Let's get into what the Falcons are thinking at four. And you said, you know, you think they're going to take a quarterback. On your mock, though, you have them doing what I think they should do. You got Matt Ryan for 2 years on a contract, at least, that you have redone and know it'll be so expensive to get out of it. You got Julio Jones. When he's healthy, he's still Julio Jones. Calvin Ridley is stupendous. You put Kyle Pitts there, go to work, and see who can beat you 40 to 30. Go for it. And Arthur Smith, the offensive mindset that he can bring to the equation here. It's just too much to pass up, because when Ryan's done, you got Pitts there as a Hall of Fame potential talent for the next guy, with Ridley, I might add, for a long time to come. What do you think?
Pitts, I've been doing this for 20 years, Rich, and I've never given a tight end a grade this high. I mean, that's how different he is. And listen, like, you can call him a wide receiver in a tight end's body, whatever you want to do. But his wingspan, his ability to get off the press, his ability to separate with his feet, and then to go up and make contested catches, in addition to making yards after contact and yards after catch, it's rare. You don't find a guy like that. So, you match him up with Julio and Calvin Ridley, and all of a sudden now, like, you're giving your organization a chance to make a run the next couple of years. And I know Matt Ryan's not going to be there forever, but he's been durable. He's been productive. We know he can still play the game. I would go Kyle Pitts, but I also know that the organization is looking at it and saying, all right, we're not planning to draft at number four again. We plan on being, you know, a playoff team. So it's a very difficult decision, but I think there's no question the first three picks are going to be quarterbacks. San Francisco didn't move up from 12 to 3 to take a linebacker or a guard, or, you know, they're taking a quarterback. So do you take that fourth quarterback? Are you in love with that guy? Or do you take the best non-quarterback on the board, and that's Kyle Pitts?
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.